Hi, hello, and welcome to Dzyner by Design. What if I told you that this title portion of this video was created in PowerPoint with zero animation steps? Today's video is all about that. You might be familiar with the animations tab, but in this video, I'm going to show you a special transition effect called Morph. Let's see how it works. Morph does a lot of heavy lifting for you. All you have to do is create the slide with the starting look of the slide and the target look in the next slide. Say for example, I draw a rectangle in my first slide. Then select the slide and duplicate it. In the second slide, I change the position, size, and the color of the rectangle. Once done, from the transition tab, select Morph. That's it. To see this effect, click on F5 or the preview button. PowerPoint does the animation for you. It's that easy. You can do this with shapes, images, or even text. Let me show you how you can use this effect for a creative text reveal effect. Step 1. Let me draw a rectangle and set the height and the width as 0. This is going to be my starting look of the slide. Now, duplicate the slide. Select the zero size rectangle and set the height and width. Next, select the morph from the transition tab. Let's see the preview. Isn't it nice? Okay, moving on to step number 2. Add the desired text. To make it appear as if it is coming out of this rectangle, position the text to the left side of the rectangle. To hide the text, draw another rectangle to the left side of this existing rectangle and color it as like the background color, which is white. Also, set the text color as white. Next, in step 3, duplicate the slide, color the text, and position the text where you want it to be after it's revealed. Now, click on Preview to see the effect. Isn't it amazing? Now that you understand how Morph works, let's see how I made this title video. As you see, it's just a sequence of 11 slides that uses Morph transition. The first slide has the first text, Hi. The next slide has where I want the Hi text to be with a long shadow text effect, and my second text, which is Hello. The preview shows how the morph transition happens. Likewise, in the next slide, I kept duplicating it and placing the necessary text and leave the rest to PowerPoint. Okay, finally, I have an example to show face morphing effect. I have two pictures on two slides. On the first slide, I have a picture of Angelina Jolie. The second slide is a duplicate of this slide with a picture of Alyssa Milano on top of Angelina Jolie. I have set the duration of this transition as 5 seconds. Let's see the preview. It's as simple as that. Likewise, you can keep adding n number of pictures. To show you quickly, let me duplicate the last slide. Maybe take the picture of Angelina Jolie from the previous slide and place it on top of Alyssa Milano's picture. Just make sure the facial features align closely so your transition is smooth. Wow, that's amazing. Remember I told you this can be applied to text or even individual letters? Let me add a sentence in the first picture slide. Now, I'm going to copy this text to the second picture slide, but change the position and width of the sentence. And finally, copying it to the third picture slide and change the text and position. But this time, from the effects option, select characters. Are you ready to see this effects? Isn't this cool? I hope you enjoyed watching this video. For more such useful videos, subscribe to Dzyner by Design. See you in another video. Bye now.